Today we are going to discuss about the BOP test. How we are going to do the BOP test and what are the safety measures we have to take whenever we are doing BOP test. So before we are going to discuss about the BOP test, after viewing our videos in our channel, if you like, please subscribe. So now we are discussing about the general BOP testing procedures. We are using to test the BOP water, not the mud, because it is having less compressibility than mud. Make up testing assembly and set into a wellhead profile. So you should know how they are make upping the testing assembly. So we will show you. Yes, see, this is what test plug we are using to place this one in wellhead. After that we will test the BOP. So how we will insert it into the wellhead, we will now you will see how we are inserting into it. Okay, we are see now here, this is what wellhead outer this outer side is called wellhead. And in this wellhead we will place the test plug. So in order to place this test plug inside, so you see this one, this portion should be removed. This acts like a protector for the wellhead. So after removing this one only, we will place the test plug in that. So now you will see how they are placing this test plug. So like this they are placing the test plug. This is in blue color, you see this is what the test plug they are inserting into this one. After that they will remove this wire bush, remove this wire bush. In name itself it is having wire, so it it helps to save the wellhead because of movement of drill string continuously inside the wellhead. So that is the purpose of air bushing. So with the help of this test plug, they will insert into this air bushing. After matching this one, they will remove the air bushing. After they will run this test plug in a reverse direction, and then they will start BOP test. So like this, this is the first image. That is what the normal condition of the wellhead. This is the second one and this is the third. This is the position of well BOP testing. This is the position of BOP test. You see it is in inverse position. Okay, now we will see what is the procedure of the this is the procedure of BOP testing. Make up testing assembly and set in into a wellhead profile. So now we see how the test plug is inserted into the wellhead by removing the wire bushing. Ensure that casing walls must be left open. It is very very important before commencement of the BOP test. If the people they are not open the casing wall, then there is a chance of any valve, any bolt will get damaged, and it's come like a bullet and it strike anywhere and it can cause fatality. Open, then there must be a personal monitoring the outlet of casing walls all the time while testing. So why? Because he will notice that if nothing will leak, something is happening wrong, then immediately he will inform the people who are in cementers. They are giving the input pressure, so then immediately they will stop the testing of BOP. You must ensure that personnel who are monitoring the outlet must stay away from the BOP. Otherwise the person who is in the monitoring, he will be in the danger while it is being tested. The reason behind this step is to prevent pressure build up in the casing. If the test plug is leaking, circulating through choke kill lines, choke manifold, standpipe manifold and valves to ensure that all lines are full with water. This practice is preventing pressure dropping off while testing. So it is very very important one. Ensure that all lines are full with water. This practice is for preventing pressure dropping off while testing. Line up cement unit. We have to connect a section line from the BOP assembly to cementing unit. And rig team shut ramps. They will close the ramps of the BOP and valves as per rig specific testing sequence. Pressure test must be low and high respectively, and the pressure should be stabilized with minimum bleed of at least 5 minutes. Ensure that pressure recording on a chart is recorded accordingly, correctly. Ensure that any equipment does not pass pressure test requirement must be reported to supervisor. Then immediately they will change or maybe replacement of the new part. Continue pressure testing until all equipment is tested as per each rig specifications. Rig down testing assembly once the test is finished. So this is the information about the BOP test. So this is the BOP you see here. So the proportion is the annual preventer, upper ram, lower ram, mean pipe ram, that is what shear ram. So they are using different purposes. See here, the person is standing near to the BOP. So whenever at the time of BOP testing, at that time they will lose these bolts and he will stay away from the BOP. He is not in the direct contact or maybe near to the BOP. Otherwise, whenever they are testing, it causes a severe damage. Okay, this is what the test plug we are already seen and discussed about this one. This is very very important one. And these are the how the position of the test plugs, and this is the information about the BOP. This is what the BOP. So okay viewers, I hope you understand good about how to do the BOP test. Not only this for BOP test, they are also doing the same process for the choke manifold. They are removing all the equipment from the BOP after testing the BOP. Then they will connect the same thing to the choke manifold. They are also doing the same thing. All the valves are closed, and after checking the choke manifold, then they will release the pressure of that water to outside by flushing the water with the help of cementing unit. So like that they are testing all the equipments. Mostly they are using, they are doing this test for every 15 days, that is every 2 weeks, depends upon the operation. If need by the supervisor, they are deciding the changing of the testing also, but it is mandatory for doing every 15 days they should have to do the BOP test. Okay viewers, I hope you understand well about how to do the BOP test. Thank you.